I've done the last two of these, prompted by the suicide of Robin Williams. I've tried to get to the heart of the matter, but I don't think I've done a very good job. Williams' abrupt end shocked many people, even though you could see it coming from several thousand miles away. Williams was never playing for nickels and dimes. He was all in. Reasons are given. His sentimental nature, his childlike approach to life, his vulnerability, the alcohol and drug abuse, messy personal life, two huge alimonies, heart surgery, incipient Parkinson's disease, or you simply look in the mirror and see the astonishing wreckage of flesh that you've become. It becomes a question only of exactly which straw would break him. The one thing we can't do now is make fun of this, which is odd because Williams stuck his pointed wit into everything. We can't say we know a man hitches his pants up higher as he gets older, but no, Robin, the belt goes around the waist, you know? Or we can't try to explain that he did this because he couldn't face another season of the crazy ones. No, seriously, he told his agent, you tell those bastards to cancel that fucking thing, or I'm going to have to do something drastic. What makes his suicide so jarring is that it seems so unlikely, so sad an end for such a funny man. That's what I've been chasing about for the past two pieces here. It turns out that comedy is a serious business, and Williams was a thoughtful man, very self-aware. What you call a comedy tour, I'm sorry, when you call a comedy tour weapons of self-destruction, you're playing a dangerous game. When you say that stand-up is kill or die, you mean it. Let's say you can choose between the two, between comedy and tragedy. Comedy seems to be the preferable choice, don't you think? You get to be the life of the party. You can whoop it up. Put it this way, do you want to be with Jackson Pollock or Mark Rothko? We can go over to Jackson's, hang out, have some beers, smoke a little weed, goof around, maybe go into town and scare up some babes. Or we can go over to Mark's, smoke cigarettes and stare at the wall. The thing is, after following radically different paths, they come to quite the same end. And Robin Williams was no exception. There are no exceptions. Comedy is about beginning, again and again and again. Tragedy is about the end. So the comedian begins, again and again, stubbornly, wildly, defiantly, until he sees ultimately that he has run out of beginnings. He doesn't want to begin again. He's willing to embrace, or at least accept, the end. He who laughs last, laughs best. Maybe so, but I'm telling you, that last laugh is a real bitch. It's a howler.